Project Watch. This is Sir P. Now today I'm going to be talking mostly about Haiti and what happened to their president. Now of course I don't cover foreign issues on this channel, but this video was originally supposed to be a Patreon exclusive. But every now and then I like to share a video that is only for Patreon on the main channel, so people have a taste of the kind of things I will talk about over there. Just like the video about are you man in yard or man in the yard, this is another one of those. So we're going to talk about it. As me say many times, Patreon link is in the description. The link come up on your screen. I don't know where to find the details, right? So Haiti, from the video yesterday, I told you without knowing anything about what happened that was a Haitian inside job. Whenever I make videos like this, people normally hit me up to say, Sir P, you must have some kind of crystal ball. You don't need a crystal ball to know that there is no way a group of men can go for the president of Haiti, right? And at least 10-15 of them they lie down on the ground flat. You see, the people in Haiti, right? Alright, well, some of the journalists in Haiti, because it look like some of the public fall feed, but this is what the ambassador, right, had to say about the incident. This is some news clip, right? It's fair use, but I'm gonna make you listen to it. Check this out.
Servants had been tied up.
We need to understand what happened.
Haiti's ambassador to Canada says investigators now believe some police officers were involved in the attack. The home is in a residential neighborhood with multiple security checkpoints and police officers who are supposed to be acting as guards.
You don't need a PhD in astrophysics to know that. You don't need a PhD in a chemistry to stop and say, hold on. Then, what made the guard them? Them should have a hell of a time just getting into the property. Them should have just the initial shootout between them and the security guard them and the police them would have given the president enough time, right, to barricade himself and then back up and forward. Alright, so the first voice I hear is a journalist, right, foreign journalist attack. Now you are going to hear the Haitian ambassador attack. Check this out.
The fact that the president and his wife were practically the only person killed, that means the someone opened the door for them.
Now, this is not about being lucky. This is not about taking a wild guess. As far as I'm concerned, this is common sense. Somebody had to look the other way. Somebody had to turn the next cheek. There is no way them should have get to the president so fast. No way. You don't need psychic powers if you know that. You don't need a crystal ball to figure that out. See there? Journalists are asked how the man them could penetrate the president's home, his security detail, and in panic room, and then escape unarmed, but then work hard without planning a successful getaway. This is one of the biggest Mickey Mouse stunts I've ever seen. This wasn't, now that the smoke clear and we can look on it better, this is not even a sophisticated operation. This is puppy shooting. And you see the man there with them catch everybody? No, we must soon get into that. But the fact that this has bamboozled Jamaicans, and Jamaicans think this is some kind of high level, big time ops planned by Uncle Sam and to get out there, makes me worry about Jamaica. Makes me worry, right? And trust me, this does show me that Jamaica is not ready for the big leagues. Then Jamaica is not ready for the big leagues. The fact that people couldn't sit down and that makes sense and add up. The fact that this is bamboozling people really think this is some kind of high-level, complex, big-time Uncle Sam operation. I mean, as bad as Uncle Sam may be, put a little respect for Uncle Sam's name, please. This is a gimmicks operation. Let me explain something to you. Them money couldn't get in a year yard as fast as all them getting at the president's yard. All the president had to do was barricade himself. Let me say that again. All the president had to do was barricade himself. Think about this, a regular Jamaican citizen. Because this happened in the Cherry Garden of Haiti. This happened in the Narbrook of Haiti. How quick, if a normal citizen can have them King Alarm and them Hawkeye, if you get response team, not only that they call police and police come to you. How fast do you think police will reach the president yard? How fast, assuming no security in the zero, the moment the first shot fire and the president go up on the phone, hello, me need help. How fast do you think they will reach? They will reach before a penny can drop on the ground. Where was the response team? Where was the security detail? In here, the man said they opened the gate and let them in. Come on, people of Jamaica. This is we sit and listen to the dominant argument for the dinner. Let me see what the dominant, what the majority think. People really don't see what happened right now. Inside job, you have crystal ball? No, but I have sense. Where was the security detail? This is the president of Haiti. A man who had already had an assassination attempt. A man who was under so much heat. I wonder if you realize how big his security detail is. You want me to show you? Look on your screen. Check this out. There was also said to be no reports of an exchange of rounds between the guards and the attackers, which raised some eyebrows. Raised some eyebrows? Link me for some unicorns. It raised eyebrows and raised the price of my unicorns. That's what it raised. You think eyebrows alone raised? Me just raised the price of my unicorns. If you did link me yesterday, will I get a better price? But know that me see. Right, what the majority, what the dominant voice thinks, even people miss it on social media, people who are supposedly intellectuals and all this, now that's messy how them look on situations and break it down. Sorry, but my double the price, I'm unicorns. This is what it's come to. Damn right, eyebrows raised. Where was the hell of a shootout? Now from yesterday, I said that even without having no details, because you'll be hearing this video on Friday, but that Thursday evening, I see this article. Where was the exchange of rounds? This is the president of Haiti. It should have been the mother of all shootout. It's weird, see left on your screen, it's weird that there was no one fighting back. Isn't that weird, Mr. Laurent? It's very weird. No one, the president, noting that the presidential guard usually has a detachment of 100 officers. The president of Haiti, man, see there? Usually, not in a times of crisis, you know, in a times of crisis that it had probably gone up. Standard procedure. Because, you see, Jamaica have a high crime rate, Jamaica don't really know any political instability like that. Maybe in the 70s, a little thing here and there, yes. But for the most part, Jamaica is politically stable. Jamaican leaders can move on with a 2-car, 3-car convoy. In a countries like Haiti, when the president a move, you have to about 100-man station. You know, 100-man station? Well, you have to about 100-man detachment. 100 men have to roll around with the president. When in the yard, 100 men are watching him back. 100, usually. And on this night, what everybody take Panada, what them take Fenzik, what them belly that hurt them, and the whole of them the tiles at the same time, where were they? Who can stand down? Who can stand down police? Who can stand down military? Who can stand down security? Other Haitian officials. This is an inside job. This is the easiest inside job. This doesn't even require no kind of high level digging. It's weird that there was no one fighting back. I just see a man them get him out. Let me tell you something. One of the hardest thing you'll ever do. Well, not the hardest thing you'll ever do, but one of the hardest thing somebody can do. People who are in military law enforcement is to clear a building. Clearing a building is one of the hardest thing. One person will barricade themselves properly in our house, it take hours to get them out. Hours. I don't talk about a presidential house with a safe room. I talk about a regular house. If somebody just lock up themselves in the right room and lock off themselves in a position where rush them have access to a window, and you are try to clear the room to get to them, you try to clear the building to get to them, you're there for hours, spent up for hours. So all the money just go in, wipe out the president and gone just so. Come on, people, think about it. Clearing a house is difficult because they literally don't know what they're on the next corner. You know who can run in and run back out fast? Man who 100% sure they're not getting resistance. You need to be 100% sure so you will not get any resistance. And who can give you that assurance? The very same guards them. The very same guards them can give that assurance. Inside job, them just make the foreigners and the dirty work. Right. So far, right, 15 of the men with them catch come from Colombia. Couple of them are Haitian Americans. One of them was in charge of some bodyguard unit for the Canadian embassy that is CM Haiti. Right. People I see them find man in a bush, residents hold up a man in a bush and hand him over to police. This whole thing is a farce and a gimmick. Hold on, find man in a bush, this elite team of mercenaries. You're trying to convince me that a team of mercenaries, foreign mercenaries, left their country, gone now next man country with no escape plan? Any self-respecting team of mercenaries, if these men were truly top shelf, the first question they ask before they get the call, the first question they ask after them here say, we want to take out our president, the first question they ask, or the escape will go. You can't walk when a no man country got to call nobody without an escape plan. And them little man, they go in a one wall horse or catch every man sit down there. Oh, and the ambassador horse and them catch about 20 of them in the horse and sit in the lie down there. Not only that, then just so happen to have the man of all them passport on them, you know, man of them passport, man of them visa, man of them, man they walk with all them documents, you know. Man, them walking in Haiti, a country where they don't even need plane for going. Jamaicans paddle pan boat go Haiti. Jamaicans paddle pan boat go Haiti. Right. And them man, yeah, right, take plane, gone with them real passport, walk through real airport, right, and then carry them passport with them, gone pan apps, right, go for the president, take him out, no resistance on the way in. No resistance on the way out, but managed to lift and go out and then reach a yard now. Then all of a sudden police just catch them and catch them with passport, catch them with documents, man of all TRN. Man of them TRN, man of letter signed by a doctor, man of one letter signed by one JP. Right? What kind of gimmick is this? What kind of a Simon? Like a Simon, they might have to do the work. Let me tell you something. You see, if that was anything high level, if that was Uncle Sam work, the man they go on that wouldn't even exist on paper. On paper, they would not exist. You not find no passport, no license, no name. And them man, when they catch them, those men are trained. For tell you, nothing at all. You can fling on all the lick you want to fling on. This is not the work of Uncle Sam. I know that's the more exciting theory. I know that's just a juicy story, but this is not the work of Uncle Sam. These men are not elite. These men are not Delta. These men are not SEALs. These men are not CIA. It's Mickey Mouse thing. As me say, 15 of the men come from Colombia. The one them are American or Haitian American. Them have ties back to Haiti. Like he makes thing. Imagine the man then go with all them TRN. Me see them a postman travel documents. Me a go in a man country if you go take out. Then president, a country where me can take a boat, me can link a Jamaican. Me can link a Jamaican fisherman. And him carry me in Haiti without needing no papers. Right, but me and 40, 50 man, I go through the airport. Grandpa apps with my passport. Joke thing. We leave half away, you see? And none away here. Or is it half away here and none away, you see? Complete. Listen, the Haitian 116s them pull off one of the biggest Disney stunts we've seen this year. A stunt this. Mickey Mouse stunt. See them Haitian insiders them get him out and use foreigner man for do it. You see the man with them catch, two things happen. either one of them really do it, but after them do it, them get set up back by the same Haitians them who wipe them out. Or two, they are patsies. Just some, because some of them and them say my whole lamp and I throw their back of the jeep, them man look at them Kevin Freeman Stone. Right. Man look confused like them and say, oh, what go on? But you don't understand, Simon is the most of the person weird stuff, so, but me didn't have one back. Man look confused. Some of them man look confused, so I say, it's either them get set up back, because that's how it works, you know, enough time. Man hire you for work, and them man send them up on the mission, and when they finish the mission, right, then them come back and get rid of you. And then them look like a hero. Or two, as me say, apatsies. Meaning, I do some little man them throw under the bus. Because the whole passport and visa and permanent residency card and TRN and all, I don't know what kind of operatives are going to man place and I carry them document with them. Everything false. If you have papers for you, everything false. Right. You don't need a document to go. Haiti have one of the weakest borders in the world. This right there, sir. Haitian 116 is the behind of this. Haitian big wigs the behind of this. Feed them ups. Them just never get them hands dirty. Matter of fact, right now, enough of them. I play the role of hero, capturing the men who dare to do this to the president. Smoke and mirrors. Smoke and mirrors. But that's geopolitics. This is big boy geopolitics. This is not the Klansman one order Mickey Mouse foolishness. This is treason of the highest order. But, as me say, not many people in Haiti have shed tears for him. And all them I go do, I make an example of the man where them say them catch, where them say do it, right? Clap them hand and say, well done team, well done police, well done security forces, we catch them, alright, time to move on. Right. Yeah. As I said, it's a big boy thing, big boy leagues. Anyway, Patreon squad, big up on yourself. Alright, this video was supposed to be exclusively for you, but maybe not enough for sure. Alright, I'll look at one video, the people and let them know I want on Patreon. PIA, you don't know, more life. Ultra squad, stay circling. Bless.